That's why I like to think and look at stocks. David, the market is cheering the stimulus package, is it not?
I really don't think so, Larry, but I do think it's cheering. I
thought for sure you'd say yes.
Yeah, look, the NASDAQ was up over 400 today. It was down 400 yesterday and the first day after they had passed it over the weekend. The Dow was up 29 points today. There's sort of a trading range right now for the Dow. The NASDAQ's had more volatility. Everything what you said is what's going on. The market loves the vaccination success. It loves economic recovery. It loves Disneyland reopening. It loves fans in Wrigley Field. Mm. That's what the market's responding to.
You know, Dave Bonson, as Liz P. correctly noted, the stock market does love stimulus. And now there's another stimulus package. Behind this one, as you know, you're very well informed, you two, there's $4 or $5 trillion stimulus package. It's being labeled infrastructure. It's really a Trojan horse for the Green New Deal. And that's really a Trojan horse for massive tax hikes to pay for it, like carbon taxes and gasoline taxes and taxing rich people and so forth. Is that going to be good for the stock market? I mean, after all, people will argue it's more stimulus.
Well, the reality is that that type of thing is not able to get through right now with 5-vote lead in the House and 50-50 in the Senate. They're not going to have the votes for something so draconian. And then we're going to go into a midterm election year next year. There's a lot of bad things they want to do that are not stimulative, as you know, but that would hurt stocks. But I don't believe they have the political ability right now to get it done. But I really want to point out everything Liz said is right. All of her arguments about what's going on, helping stocks in the economy, better vaccinations, people traveling again. It's just that none of that has anything to do with stimulus. The premises and the conclusion are a non sequitur here. The reality is it's people exercising freedom.
Well, okay, but I think the argument's going to be made. More stimulus is good. I mean, I just think that I don't want to politicize this more than I need to. But your point is an interesting point. We'll just end on that. The market obviously knows all information. The market knows that this big Green New Deal package is coming. And the market knows, you know, Senator Manchin said it on Sunday, there are going to be tax hikes to pay for it, and carbon taxes, gasoline taxes, and, you know, the Democrats' liberal program to tax rich people and corporations and whatnot. So David, you're saying the market knows it won't pass. Let's start with you. I want to get Liz's take on this. So the market can predict politics. I mean, that's part of its Weltanschauung.
It can't predict it. It can try to price it. It can try to discount it.
The risky thing that's happened here is that politically, Biden went out on a limb, passed this enormous bill with no Republican votes. He could have gotten a bipartisan package, $2 trillion, and focused on infrastructure instead of bailing out blue states and spending money on the teachers' unions and all the things that have pumped up this bill. Well, I think it was a real mistake, and I think that'll come home to roost a little bit.
That's just way too reasonable. Way too reasonable. David Bonson, I want to ask you a question. Based on your optimism, and you think President Biden is going to take credit for the vaccines, the economy, and the stock market? You think he might?
Yeah, I have a little funny feeling. I think every president in history and their supporters take too much credit, and I think their opponents give too much blame. It's part of the politics, but the one entity that sees through it all is the market.
All right, that's good. We'll close on that. Liz Peek, David Bonson, thank you both ever so much.